With Europe's busiest underground railway at a virtual standstill, the only way for hundreds of thousands of Londoners to get to work was to walk. Commuters took to the streets like armies to beat the strike.
I've been walking for about half an hour.
Do you mind walking?
No, I don't mind.
Overall, my whole journey would take 2 hours, which is about an hour more than usual, so...
Do you mind walking?
A little bit, yeah.
I'm walking from Euston to Bayswater this morning.
How long's that going to take you?
About an hour.
No other way of getting to work?
I've tried the buses, the queues are ridiculous.
And at the bus stop, scenes like these were typical.
How long have you been waiting for a bus now?
About 25 to half an hour.
Is it causing you a lot of inconvenience to strike today?
Far too much inconvenience, yeah. It's been a complete nightmare, really.
And when buses did arrive, they were too crowded to get on. So many motorists took to the roads, the AA said average travelling speeds in central London were down to just 3 miles an hour. Some chose pedal power, others waited for taxis. And if the queues were anything to go by, they certainly had a long wait. Fewer than 30 trains ran, mainly on the Victoria and Northern lines. But for the lucky commuters, it was no easy ride.
Horrible.
It's been packed more than anything else. It's been really, really squashed. No air in the trains or anything.
Wonderful, yeah. Great, yeah. Bit hot.
And to add to the heat, British Rail Guards at Marylebone walked out on strike today in a dispute over staffing levels. Tonight, 75% of trains out of the station are cancelled. But as far as the tubes are concerned, more action seems inevitable. Peace talks are expected later this week, but with little prospect of a settlement, strikes at least once a week look set to continue. A gloomy prospect then for thousands of commuters tonight nursing their aching feet. This is Mike Pearce for Thames News.